For part 5, we'll explore the normal distribution. Or more specifically, how can we find the probability that x is less than a number or more than a number if we know x follows a normal distribution? All right, so let's explore this example. Suppose test scores in a class are normally distributed, so they follow a bell curve, with an average of a 76 and a standard deviation of 8. Find the probability that a student scored less than an 81. So just drawing out what's been said, we know the x's are supposed to follow a normal distribution. So let's draw a normal distribution. And since these are x values, let's label this with an x. We know the average score is supposed to be a 76. And maybe just for reference, let's write down what the standard deviation is as well. So we know the average is a 76, and the standard deviation is an 8. We want to find the probability that x is less than 81. So 81 would be to the right of 76 over here. And since we want to find the probability that x is less than 81, let's shade to the left. All right, so we want to find this probability. Well, if we're going to use the z-table for this, the z-table gives us z-values. So we need to find the z-values associated with these x-values. Well, we already know that since z-scores measure the number of standard deviations you are from the mean, that the z-distribution is centered around 0. So the 76 is associated with a 0. But let's find this 81 here. So if you just to recall, remember our z-score formula is just x minus mu over sigma. So let's use it to find the z-score of 81. So z would be equal to 81, because that's our x value, minus 76, our average, over the standard deviation, which is 8. If you do this calculation, you get 5 over 8, which, let's take out my calculator, is exactly 0.625. Sorry, I got cut off a little bit there. Well, then remember our z-table only goes to 2 decimal places. So we have to round this, and we're going to get z is approximately 0.63. Looking this up on the table, 0.6 is over here, and 3 is over here. So where they cross is over here. So that means the area between 0 and 0.63, this area, is going to be 0.2357. And we know the area to the left of 0 is going to be 0.5. So if we add those together, that will give us the probability someone scores less than an 81. So the probability that x is less than 81 would be 0.2357 plus 0.5, which would be 0.7357. And that's our answer. Okay, you're going to want to practice this a lot. It's going to be the same technique over and over, but just practice it because it's much easier to watch me do it than to actually do it yourself. So just practice, you'll get it. Alternatively, you can also do this on your calculator, and I'll link to a video to show you how. Only some calculators have that feature, though. Okay, let's go backwards. Suppose instead we're given a probability and we want to find an x value. And what we're going to do is we're going to do the entire procedure exactly backwards. I know that sounds a little weird, but that's what we're going to do. So, right, our formula for a z-score, right, was x minus mu over sigma. So we're going to have to use the formula backwards. We're going to do everything backwards. Like, in other words, before we started off with a x value, from that we used a formula to get a z, and from the z we looked it up on a table to get the probability. So we're going to have to, we're doing everything backwards. So we're going to have to use the table to get the z values, and then use the formula backwards from the z values to get the x values. So we're just going to do everything backwards here. Since we're going to be using the table backwards and the formula backwards, let me show you what the formula backwards looks like. Well, we could use algebra to solve, but you'll be given this formula on the test the way after we solve it. But to solve this, we would just multiply both sides by sigma, and we'll get z sigma equals x minus mu. And then if you add mu to both sides, and I just flip this around here, you'll get x equals mu plus z sigma. All right, so we're going to use this formula when we go backwards. So suppose that same class, and suppose the instructor decides that they want to give an A grade to the top 10% of students. So logical question is, what is the cutoff grade? What grade must a student receive to get an A? All right, so looking at what we have, again, we know we have a normal distribution. We know the average score is a 76. We know we're going to want x values. These are x values, and we know that z is centered around 0. We're going to need both. We know the top 10% of students would be somewhere up here, because this would be about maybe 10%, 0.1 or 10%. So what we need to do is we need to find the z-score, which we'll use the table for, and then use the z to get the x, because we're doing everything backwards here. All right, so looking at the z-table, remember the outside of the z-table is the z-scores. You know, the column headers and row headers are the actual z-score. The inside is the probabilities. So what we need to do is we need to look up the probability being 0.1 or really, well, we'll talk about that in a moment. We need to look up the probability and find a z from that. But these probabilities inside are these probabilities. The probability between 0 and some z value. So we have to figure out what this is first. And this would just be 0.4 because we know 0.4 plus 0.1 would be 0.5, which is half the curve, which is what we want. So let's look at 0.4 again in the meat of the table where all the probabilities are. And if you look in the table, they do go in order, and we don't see 0.4 exactly, but we see a number pretty close. This 0.3997 is pretty close to 0.4. So we'll use that. And from that, we just need to figure out what the z value is associated with it. So looking left, we see the first two numbers are 1.2, and the last digit would be 8. So we get 1.28 is our z-score. All right, so from this, we're going to use our formula that x equals mu plus z sigma to figure out what the actual x value is. So x is equal to, well, mu we said was 76. Our z score is 1.28. And our standard deviation was 8. Let's see, where are we? Okay, so just take out a calculator and do this math. So we get 76 plus 1.28. times 8, and we get 86.24. So any student that receives above an 86.24 will receive an A. So maybe approximately 86 if the instructor's feeling a little generous, or 87 if they're feeling a little stingy. So they need at least an 86. In order to get an A. And that's our answer.